Hey gang, I'm Travis.
And I'm Imabel.
And some of you guys might be worried about us right now because there's Germans scaling fences, and I heard they're looking for Americans, and they're even blasting right through any Filipino military that stand in their way. But don't worry, we're all fine here. And if you're in the Philippines, you know what's going on. If you're outside the Philippines, I don't think this has hit international news, but basically there's been an incident where a Filipino transgender was murdered and the suspect is a United States Marine. And instead of taking the approach that, okay, there's been a tragedy, there's been a murder, and we have a suspect, let's go through the legal process and find out what the deal is and go about it from there, it seems that the local media has tried to turn this into a story where the angle is, it's us against them. It's the Philippines versus the evil United States that are here, and they're taking advantage of the Filipinos and committing crimes, and they're bad people and that kind of thing, instead of just looking at it as the acts of any one individual. But they're showing footage of college students burning American flags, and they even have local politicians, you know, joining in on the fight, and some of them are kind of taking that, oh, this American military is evil, the Americans are bad. But if you were outside the country and you saw this stuff, this footage on TV, you could really get the impression that Filipinos hate Americans right now because it's not being presented as the acts of one person that most of the facts haven't even come out on yet. But first of all, you're a Filipino. Do you hate Americans?
Of course not. Like what you already said, and I agree with that, it's an act of one person towards another. It's not like Philippines versus America or vice versa. First of all, I believe that both parties, the family of the transgender is grieving, and I'm sure the family of the Marine officer is also upset with what happened. So I think the best thing to do now, instead of judging them and stuff like that, is to pray for them, that they would have that strength and wisdom to deal with everything. And another thing is that I think, because people have been saying like VFA, the Visiting Forces Agreement, should be terminated.
A lot of people want to abolish.
Yes.
They want to get the American military out of the Philippines, because they say, oh, these guys are causing all this trouble. Never mind that after Typhoon Yolanda hit, who had the boots on the ground? The United States were there helping people. And for every incident like this, you probably have hundreds or thousands of instances of them helping local people, if for no other reason than providing protection from foreign invaders like China.
Yeah, I think this incident should not be the main basis or a basis to decide to terminate or abolish VFA just because of that. Why not magnify the good things or the advantages of that agreement and not focus on what just happened? Anyway, this is not like, this is a big deal, of course, but it has...
It's a tragedy, we're not trying to make fun of it, to be clear.
It will, and it can go through the due process, so... Let it be. It doesn't have to affect the VFA, and you know, who knows what really happened. So there would be hearings and all that, so let's just wait. And
most of what's out, there hasn't been too many facts that have come out yet. The only thing they know is that these people met in a bar. The Marine met the transgender woman, and they went to a hotel together, and then later the transgender was found dead. There's a witness that has said that the Marine did not know that it was a transgender. Mm-hmm. And there's a lot of speculation, and this is just speculation. I'm not trying to put misinformation out there, but there's a lot of speculation, including coming from a lot of Filipinos, that are theorizing that the Marine didn't know, and therefore he was tricked into doing a sexual act with the transgender. And if you have sex under false pretenses, then it's rape. And that doesn't justify someone taking the law into their own hands and committing that act by any means, but then it complicates the issue and that speculation, and everyone seems to be speculating about this case because the real deal is we don't know most of the facts about it. But the president has come out and said that he's not going to junk the visiting forces agreement over this one incident, which was the right thing to do. And you have other politicians saying, yeah, we need to kick out the United States. We can't let them in our country. And there's other groups that are maybe pushing an agenda where they have their reasons. But it's kind of, to me, it seems it's either very ignorant or very selfish, because they're not taking into consideration, like, what if we have another typhoon? You know, the United States helps us out. They're not taking into consideration, especially the politicians, that China's been creeping into the Philippines. In fact, there was that one Senator Santiago, she said she wants to get the military out, but if you read the story on Yahoo, all the comments are like, oh, she must be working for China, or I'm sure China's very happy to hear this. But there was an incident yesterday that it's been all over TV, it was captured on camera, where the sister of the transgender, the suspect, the U.S. Marine, he's been brought to a local Filipino fort, and he's under custody of the United States. That's per the VFA agreement, but he's being held at a Filipino fort now. And then the whole thing is a big zoo, and you had the sister of the transgender climbing the fence trying to get to him, and then the German fiance, he scales the fence, pushes a Filipino soldier. And what happens to these people? Are they arrested? Is he being deported? No, nothing. It's pretty amazing to watch the Filipino military basically allow this to happen. They're letting people scale the fences at their facility, letting a guy, especially a guy that's from another country, just push the soldier. No retaliation. Now, let me say, I think it's great that you don't have military people that are overly aggressive, overzealous, people that can show restraint. I think that's great, but it's kind of silly to let someone scale the fence at a military facility and push a soldier. And the German guy was on TV today. He apologized because he admitted, well, that was a very rude thing to do and a very disrespectful. But then he had the excuse that, well, I saw the American Marines that were guarding where the suspect is, I saw them laughing. It's like, first of all, we know that you suffered a loss and we know that you're the fiance, but the bottom line is, you're a random guy from Germany and you have no authority, not only over the Filipino military, but you're not going to tell the United States Marines when they're allowed to laugh, when they're not allowed to laugh. You're not the dictator. You're not the Führer. You don't get to tell people what to do, dude. And you got to understand, from the U.S. Marines, if they were laughing, it's probably because it was in disbelief that the security was so lax that they're allowing people to scale the fences, not making arrests. And I'm sure the Marines that were standing guard were probably thinking, yeah, I hope they make it over here. I want to see this guy try and push me. Because I'm sure they would have arrested that guy so fast, and right now he would be in U.S. custody as well. But I know I have a lot of viewers that are either current military or former military. You can tell me what military procedure would be for the United States if people were climbing the fences to get into their facility and then pushing, assaulting the soldiers. What would happen? Would the United States do nothing, or would they arrest them, or what do you happen? If you're a military person, leave me a comment and let me know. But you have military family. Is that standard procedure in the Philippines? You let guys push them around?
For sure, if it was my military officer relatives, they wouldn't be like that. But in fairness to the military officers who were there, as what I've seen on TV, is that they tried to be peaceful instead of worsening the situation, because the officer was telling the sister of the deceased to just leave the territory, the area, peacefully, or else she can be sued because she violated the rule in the camp or in that area.
They were trespassing, actually.
Yeah, they were trespassing.
But they were not arrested, and the one guy assaulted a Filipino soldier. And it's all on video, and it's amazing how nothing happened. If you also see the comments on stories online, a lot of Filipinos are going, how are these people not arrested right now?
Yep. Another thought that came to mind was this incident could happen to anyone, with whether VFA exists or not in the Philippines. I mean, that kind of incident can still happen. It just so happened it was between a Filipino and an American. You know what I mean? So I don't think people should exaggerate things.
Let me ask you this. Recently there was some people from Switzerland that were visiting the Philippines. They were murdered. How much is that on TV?
None. Only once, I think. I'm not sure.
Maybe once.
I haven't been watching the news.
Does it appear that they're trying to find those killers that killed the people from Switzerland, the tourists?
I know.
It doesn't seem that, at least not that we know of, because they're sure not talking about it. They're not trying to find those guys. What about Denise and Cedric, like the people that practically beat Vong Navarro, one of the most popular people in the Philippines? They practically beat him to death, tortured him, extorted him. Where are they? Are they in prison right now?
I'm not sure. I think so.
No, they're not.
They're not?
They were arrested for non-bailable offenses, bail, right? And the judge gave them bail anyways. First of all, they weren't even arrested for several months. Maybe the U.S. Marine can get the same judge that Denise and Cedric had that granted them bail, even though they were arrested on non-bailable offenses. The one guy in the case, they even allowed to leave the country, even though they had him on a no-fly list.
He got to escape, huh?
So maybe, you know, if that's the way it works. So you have all these other cases of criminal acts. Not much is being done, but this has been turned into a media circus. But I want you guys to know that, you know, because people are watch this and they want to visit the Philippines, and people are going, well, geez, is this a good time or a bad time to visit the Philippines because of all this, especially if you're from the United States? I can tell you this, even though the media is making this their angle and trying to play out this story to make it look like all Americans are bad and, you know, it's the evil United States and it's our country versus theirs, I don't believe the general public, the general person on the street, has that feeling at all. If you look at the online articles about this case, like on Yahoo or whatever, it seems just about every comment is pretty supportive of not just the United States, but even the Marine, because there is that big theory going around, that speculation that he might have actually been raped, which, like I said, doesn't excuse it, but then it complicates things. And he's going to get a lot more sympathy if that is the case, which we actually don't know yet. Now, a lot of you guys are going, but what does this mean for me? Because I know that so many of you watch this channel and you want to visit the Philippines, but if you pay attention to what's going on the local TV, it can be scary. You might be saying, is this a bad time? Maybe I should just visit Thailand instead. And trust me, I understand. But I can honestly say, I don't think much has changed. If you want to come over as a tourist, and I know it can be scary because, as we pointed out, there's a bit of a double standard where if someone victimizes you, they might not do anything to help you out. But if you get in some trouble, then they might blow it up into an international incident and portray you as an evil foreigner. But something that you can do, one quick tip I can give you to stay safe, is Filipinos can be very friendly, very welcoming, but the thing is, that can lull you into a false sense of security where you feel like this is your home and you're so welcome here. But you just got to keep in mind that no matter how friendly people are and how much you feel like this is your home, it's not your home. You're not one of them. Keep in mind you're in a foreign country, because you don't want to let your guard down. You want to have fun, but you don't want to think that you can get away with everything that you would get away with in the United States, and you can't think that the same rules that apply there apply here. You just gotta keep that in mind. And I'll give you an example. A friend of mine went to a bar with his sister, and he's not from the Philippines, but I don't know how she was dressed, but some guys made some comments kind of harassing her, and my friend got into a fight with these guys. And what happened was, even though he was fighting one or two guys that were local Filipino guys, the rest of the bar saw that, oh, there's a foreign guy fighting with a local guy, and all the local Filipinos in the bar jumped in and started helping out the guys he was fighting, even though they didn't even know what was going on, and they ended up beating him up very bad, knocking him out unconscious. And I don't say this to scare you guys. I just want you guys, when you come over, to stay safe, but keep in mind, this isn't your country. Keep in mind that you're in a foreign country, so just do your best to behave yourself, and you can do a lot to avoid trouble. What do you think for people to keep safe here?
Like what you said, Filipinos are friendly, but my friendly piece of advice is you also be wise in choosing the people you associate with, because you can just trust everyone.
We'll be coming out with some videos on safety tips, so just keep watching the channel, and when you come over, have fun and listen to us, and we'll keep you safe.